Hi, everybody. JK Calloway here at Real JK Calloway. This is Siobhan.
Yeah, that's me.
And she's confused.
Very.
They're yummy. I'm not going to whip them out for them. They're for me. Anyway, I'm going to make her watch some more Wrestling with Rhett videos. Because I like them. Shut up. Don't walk on my intro. God! The worst!
I am.
Mom! Mom. Anyway, yeah, Ryan Zane, Wrestling with Regret. Make sure you subscribe to him as she rubs her eyes
on camera. No, it's my nose. It's my nose. I've got a sinus pressure here. I don't know if I'm getting a cold or if there's something going on with our weather. We are in Minnesota, so that's always a possibility, but it hurts right here. Like, there's bricks. It's pressing.
You're welcome. So, yeah, I'm going to make her watch my top favorite WWE themes, although it's not mine, it's Brian Zane's. But they're still great, so. She likes music. Music's the best part of wrestling, you know? Some of it's very listenable words. Some of it's good.
It is.
Jim Johnson should be in the Hall of Fame, but now he got fired, which sucks. It's stupid.
Why?
Because they hired younger guys for cheaper. Granted, they're the ones making all the NXT themes, so they're good, but still, it's a shitty thing to do.
It is.
Jim Johnston was awesome. So yeah, ready?
As I'll ever be.
I bet. Hey, no ad. You can still dance to this though. Anyway. Who's that?
People.
Who do you know? People. Who's that? He does lots of impressions.
You don't say.
Mm-hmm. He's very good.
Folks, if I've said it once on this show, I've said it 100 times. Music and wrestling can be a wonderful combination. Now, in the past, I've gone negative. I've talked about some bad themes out there. But this week, I want to take things in a positive direction.
I would show you this week, worst, but you won't know a single one of them. Because there are some.
Yes, I know there are good themes out there in TNA and New Japan and what there was in WCW, but I gotta stick with what I know. Bring back the rubber band.
Rubber band. Get it?
Mm-hmm.
Number 8.
That's a good one. You like that one.
What can I say? I was a huge mark for Gangrel and the Brood when they were first around. Not even factoring Edge. In their wrestling ability, their entrance was amazing.
You like Edge.
Probably my top 5 of all time.
He's pretty.
And the music was a vital part of it. Now, when you ask yourself, what kind of music would be perfect for a vampire gimmick, what comes to your mind? Something a little less German ravey? Perfect. It's a one-of-a-kind, emblematic.
I'm guessing it was around when I didn't watch.
Creepy, gothic, and mysterious, this song is perfect for when you want to emerge out of a ring of fire and spit some of that red viscous fluid.
That's what they called it. They didn't want to say blood.
Yeah. He's got a good opening. Entrance, I mean.
Honest to God, there was a point earlier this year where this song was in my head all day, every day, for weeks, and it didn't drive me nuts. That's how I know I like it. This is just a really fun entrance theme, a perfect blend of metal and orchestral, like something out of an epic video game or movie. If you were to look at a chart that tracked the evolution of entrance music, this song would be the final form. My one big problem with it is, it only really matches up well when Finn is in demon mode. He only does that about once a month on average. When he comes out as his normal self, I can't help but think,
wow, what an awesome theme, but man, who is this skinny, pasty, bug-eyed guy in a leather jacket? This is not skinny, pasty, bug-eyed leather jacket man music.
But that's a minor nitpick in the grand scheme of things. It's still catchy as hell.
He is on.
Number 6.
You know,
classic. Yeah.
My list is going to be pretty heavy on Attitude Era themes, and if you're going to talk about epic themes from that time period, you got to talk about Stone Cold. You don't need me to go into great detail, but
you know what song it was based on?
It's the epitome of badassery.
No, but once you tell me, I'll see it or hear it.
Apparently, he went to Jim Johnson and said he wanted something like Bulls on Parade by Rage Against the Machine.
Or drink a beer, or possibly both at once, then you have no soul.
Nerd.
Number 5.
Except he's singing.
Fun fact, this is the only song on my countdown that features lyrics. But the lyrics aren't what make this song to me. I just love that catchy tune underneath. Even if you're not paying attention to whatever Shawn Michaels is yammering about, the main tune of the chorus
is pretty
righteous.
But it doesn't fit with his, the lyrics don't fit with his,
It just sounds so damn arrogant and triumphant, and it fits right in line with Shawn's character.
That's true.
Whether it's a face or a heel.
When he came back as Born Again, it didn't really fit.
By the way, how well it can work out depending on what side of the coin a wrestler is on. Not all songs are that interchangeable.
Seriously? No.
No.
Okay.
That's Bayley's theme.
I know it's Bayley's theme. That's why I was confused.
But, yeah.
It's very American.
If
my top 8 favorite wrestlers countdown went to an even 10, Kurt Angle would definitely be on that list. And his music, honestly, is one of the big reasons why.
It wasn't made for
similar
him.
Similar to Shawn Michaels' theme, Kurt's music was so awesome because it always fit him, whether
he was a good
guy or a bad guy.
Even cheesier.
But not just that, it worked when he was a goofy heel, or a serious face, or vice versa. It had equal parts triumph, bombast, power, glory, garishness, and patriotism. That last one makes sense, since the theme was originally used for Del Wilkes. The song as is
like named the Patriot.
An instant classic, but surprisingly, it gets even better when you add vocals.
Mean.
Number 3. Yes, yes, I know this was a WCW theme, but I wasn't about to call this episode my top 7 favorite WWE themes and one WCW theme. And brother, what an iconic theme this is. Of all the famous WCW themes, I would put this one above Sting, Goldberg, DDP, or...
Our dog is having a nightmare on the other side
of
the camera.
He's
yipping.
I don't always care for the cool bad guy shtick.
It's cute, he's gonna die.
Get him, get him!
He just woke him up. No?
I know I haven't been great at describing any of the songs up to this point, but now I'm really having a hard time capturing just why this song is great. It's just a tune you can't help but nod your head or play air guitar with your title belt to. And sometimes, that's all you gotta say. Mm. Number 2.
Yeah.
My dad.
Sure, Taker's current theme is iconic and it's great, but when I was just starting out as a fan, there was practically nothing out there more awesome than this short-lived theme from the late 90s. This version is very similar to the Ministry version that came out in 99, but in my opinion, I prefer this one more. The main riff, the gothic chants, the trumpet and the chorus, the wailing guitar solos peppered throughout. Just hearing the song today takes me back to a pivotal time in my life.
Ah, man, Taker's such a badass, you know? He could beat literally anybody, especially someone like Shane McMahon and, I don't know, Hell in a Cell match, just throwing that out there. That match would not even be close. It'd be over so quickly, it definitely would not be competitive, especially if the match were to happen 17 years from now, because that would be dumb.
I think what I like about this song is that while it's so unlike the Undertaker theme in existence, biker versions excluded, it conveys all the same feelings that the original one does.
I like
but
biker
at the same time,
Taker.
It
I don't
adds
care.
To the original in that regard.
Everyone hates
it's darker,
it.
Edgier,
makes me sad.
Modern,
biker Taker is
timeless.
Is your dad?
A song that reveals a much more evil side to the dead man. This theme will go down as one of my favorites. Before I reveal my number one entrant, here are a few honorable mentions. Songs I think are great, just not in my top 8.
Classic. Yeah, classic. Mm-hmm.
It sounds like there's gold dust being sprinkled in the music. Yeah, this is good. Mm-hmm.
It's your boy. He's only like 44. You can go get him. You can take out Beth Phoenix, right?
No.
I don't remember that one.
Okay. That one, that was a joke. That's not true. But come on, that song is not nearly as bad as everyone says it is.
I don't even remember
it. My number one favorite WWE theme of all time is...
I don't even remember it that much.
Dan the Beast Severn might not have had a stellar career in the WWE.
You know Dan Severn?
In my opinion, he had the coolest theme song by far. It's straightforward and badass, perfectly reflective of the Beast's chilly, heartless persona. When you heard this song,
he's
you
a lot
just
of belts.
Knew an ass beating was about
stash.
To go down. Severn didn't make the cut for the WWF Attitude game back in 99, but his theme was carried over for Dr. Death's Steve Williams, a badass song for two legit badasses. Let's compare Severn's theme to, say, Steve Austin's. Now, both had very similar ass-kicking characters, but their individual personae and their themes couldn't be any more different. They each conveyed a different tone and setting. When Steve Austin's music played...
Oh, yeah, it's on now!
Now, when Severn's music played...
Oh, shit.
It's not pretty like Finn Balor's theme. It's not epic like The Undertaker's theme. But it's rough, it's gritty, it's evocative, and it lets you know exactly what's up. That's why Dan Severn's theme is my favorite of all time. Let me know what your favorites are in the comment section below.
I don't remember that one, but okay. So good number one. Good surprise.
And buy the t-shirts at ProWrestlingTees.com. I'm Brian Zane, and I'll see you next time.
Will you know?
Mm-hmm. So what's your favorite theme of all time?
All time?
Any of the women's themes you love?
I don't know.
What's
I'd have to. I have to
you
hear
like.
Them.
Come on.
I like Shinsuke's. I like Balor's.
I made a top 10 of my favorite themes.
I would have to like. I have to hear them because I don't keep that knowledge in my brain.
Right. Well, who's your favorite females right now? Or ever?
Ever?
Yeah. Like, did you like Lita's theme more or Trish's theme more?
Lita.
But Trish had Lil' Kim.
Yeah, well.
Thanks for watching.
Thanks.
She can't think of a single theme she likes. Like Bailey's theme, it's one. It's
Bailey's
adorable.
Theme is it's adorable.
Sasha's, you like Sasha's?
I do. Yeah, But seriously, I have to hear it because it doesn't.
Victoria's, hello.
Oh, Victoria's would probably be my favorite, right? Because that was Tattoo.
That was Tattoo.
Yeah.
All the things she said song.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good song.
Well, there you go.
There we go. We'll go with Victoria's theme.
Okay. Let me know what your favorite song is in the comments. I have one, too. I'll put it in the link. I put my top 10 favorite songs out there, like a long time ago. I don't remember what it is. Thanks for watching. My name's J.K. Calloway.
I'm Siobhan as well.
For now.
Yeah, there's no for now. It's seven coming up on 17 years.
In yeah.
Like 2 weeks.
Yeah, 17 years. I dealt with this. I'm doing pretty good. She's not doing so. Oh my God. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.
Bye.
Well, thanks for watching.
I want to play Eternal Darkness now. Okay.
Why do you want to play Eternal Darkness? What? Hold on. Let's find out about this. What in the world?
The GameCube game, Eternal Darkness.
I know the game, but what in the world popped that into your head?
Well, because Tattoo's theme.
Uh-huh.
You know,
lost my mind.
Yeah, and that's Eternal Darkness. You lose your mind in the game.
You lose your sanity. You have a sanity meter.
Sanity is...
But that's like a happy pop song, and it got you to like a dark ass.
But it's
game.
Not. But it's a dark pop song.
No, it's about falling in love with a girl, when you're a girl.
Yeah, but
that's not that dark.
But it's not.
That's hot.